I'm seeing it back here, and this is going to be directly in the way. So the phone is going to be for.
Check 1, 2.
Years. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And please welcome. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you. Welcome to Cobi Narita's Celebration of Life Jazz Memorial. I have heard so many comments. I am her son. My name is Rob Narita. I have heard so many wonderful comments about my mother, and they're all true. But the last one I heard was just, it made this image in my mind. Your mother was a blazing light in the sky. Think about that. What other blazing lights are there? There are comets, there are meteors, there are huge things that you just are amazed at. That was Cobi. That was my mother. She grew up, she's raised seven kids. I'm one of seven. By herself. That gives you an idea of who she is. And for me, she's my hero. She will be. Forever. Because of what she could do. And many of you know what she could do. All these comments are just like almost overwhelming. But I wanted to personally, along with my sister Susan, who's here in the front row, we would like to thank you for being here. This is such an adventure for us. I'm a producer and I guess I'm a chip off the old block, but I have produced events like this, but never for a family member or never, most of the honored guests I didn't know in those things. They're just, somebody's paying me to do it, okay. This was a whole different ball game, folks. I know all of you. And it's for you to come out and be here with us tonight to celebrate Cobi's life is, whew, almost overwhelming. But thank you from the bottom of our hearts. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. We have a distinguished list of performers, and we'd like to start with one of Cobi's longtime, lifelong friends, Mickey Davidson. She'll be accompanied by Eli Yamin and will perform some dance for you.
Cobi was one of the most important mentors, producers, and number one fan with a mother-like flair in my life. In 2005, Cobi was presented with the Tap Dance Extravaganza's Flobert Award. Frank Owens, a longtime associate, collaborator, and friend, wrote a three-part suite for her. I'm in the process of restaging the suite to be a vehicle for making the next generations to come aware of these very two special people who worked and used their energy to give to many artistic communities. Today I will present the next generation dancers performing a restaging in progress of the instrumental version of At Cobi's Place. I look forward to present the suite in its entirety later on this spring, so keep your eyes out for it. For the dancers tonight are Shoshana Donaldson, Adante Powers, Trishina Connor, and Brandon Barker, and of course, my friend Eli Yemen on piano. And I'm not gonna forget my girls, cause me and K Kim, we go way back, so this is real family, and I don't know the drummer, but I'm gonna get to know her before the season is over. So, welcome to Cobi's Place.
Way to open this program at Cobi's Place. We have also a distinguished list of speakers this evening. The first I'd like to introduce is Wendy Oxenhorn.
Still, if you're here sitting, that means you're still standing. And it's so good to see so many of you. And I just wanted to say that Cobi really was one of the first places that ever assisted musicians. You know, before the Jazz Foundation, Jimmy Owens, thank you. And you know, Cobi kept the music alive. What I loved about Cobi, she was actually, no one knows this, she was the first person I met. When they handed me the keys to my office, they looked at me and said, "You're a one-man band, kid. Here, go and take care of the musicians." And it was hilarious because we didn't even know we had $7,000 in the bank, and that was it. So I went to this place called, I think it was the IAJE convention at the Hilton, and I had heard that Ken Burns was going to be speaking that night, so I figured I'd go hit him up for money. And I saw Cobi, and she looks at me and goes, I met her, and she was just a wealth of love. She welcomed me. I didn't know anyone in the jazz business. I didn't know anything. And she was the warmest, most wonderful woman. She was manning a booth by herself. And I think she was already 74 when I met her. And like you said, that light in the sky rocketing through. But I wanted to say that, you know, for the people who devote their lives to caring for the music, for the musicians, and making the way, making a place where the music could live. Even back then when I started the job, there were no places for people, you know, no one was paying, what was it, $50 for, you know, a three hour set, you know, two sets for 3 hours. It was crazy. And Cobi created this place where everyone could come, you know, because no one could afford to go out. It was really amazing what she did, and I wanna thank her children who cared for her and loved her. When I heard she had 7 children, I thought to myself, that deserves an award in itself. And I also just wanted to say that, you know, this is a time when, oh, by the way, when I saw the dancers, I kept having this vision of Cobi and Paul dancing, you know, and I think that they were, because she's free, the body is free. And, you know, I helped, I guess, I can't count how many hundreds of musicians to go to the next gig up there. And I want to say that it's real. There is a place. This is not anything to be afraid of. I've had enough confirmation after of life experiences of people coming back and giving me the sign, you know? So I don't want anyone to be afraid, because, you know, we all get older, and it's a beautiful, beautiful jump. It's not an end. Death is not an end. It's a beautiful beginning to someplace else. So hold that in your hearts, because the world is crazy right now. And until our time comes, just give the most beautiful amount of love you can in this world. Kindness, love, you know, instead of this whole business of being in a place of worry and fear. You know, be like Cobi. Just create the solution, you know, and love each other, because that's really what we're here for. So all of you here tonight don't even need to know that, because you all do that naturally, and I see all the faces of people I adore. I miss you. And I just wanted to say, maybe we could give one standing ovation for Ms. Cobi Narita right now. And that standing ovation is for you too. Because if you're here, it means you made it. If you're here, it means you did whatever you had to do to get to where you are now. And in the music, that's a miracle. So bless your hearts. Love you all.
Thank you so much, Wendy. Cobi had a number of passions. One of her passions was to help the less favored in our jazz community, Asian Americans, at one time, Black Americans, but still today, women. So when I was putting this together, she spoke to me and said, I'm putting together the band, the house band, women's house band. So I'm not a genius. That's where the women's house band came to be. Cobi whispered it in my ear. So tonight we have on piano Bertha Hope. The wonderful Kim Clark on bass. Luciana Padmore on drums. And the guests that will join will be Carol Sudhalter on saxophone. And Saul Zebulon on guitar.
Say a couple of words briefly. Number one, I loved Cobi very much. She helped me in many ways. And one night at my place Zeb's, where she contributed so much, after for some reason I couldn't sleep, and I woke up in the middle of the night and I heard this song, this feedback sound guy. I heard this song in my head. I woke up, I wrote this song, and I went back to sleep. And then in the morning, I woke up and I wrote the lyrics. Cobi Narita.
really loves to hear that. She loves to watch us all sing and dance. The music's not the same unless it bears the Cobi's name. I'm so glad that I met my Cobi. She has made my life more worthwhile. Happy birthday, Cobi. We all love you, darling. Thank you.
Before I introduce our next speaker, I just wanted to share something. Cobi was very sensitive to what people believed in terms of the spiritual side of life. Her husband Paul was Jewish. And when I became a born-again Christian, I asked her, would you like to come to church? And she said, no. And I thought, that's a little bit strange that she would just say no. And that's it. But I think back, she had Paul's heart in her mind when she said that. I'm her son, but that's the love of her life. Well, it turns out, I started a worship team band at my church, and she came, studied the Bible, and I got to baptize her when she was 92. My next guest is where that ball started turning, that wheel started turning. I'd like to introduce Reverend Dale Lind.
Thank you very much. It was about we decided to have a night for women and jazz, and it was after Jazz Vespers, following Jazz Vespers, the jazz had been dominated pretty much by male musicians, and except with the exception of the great Mary Lou Williams, who was a very close friend of Pastor Genzel, my predecessor. And he had her funeral here too, at St. Peter's. Representing musicians, I chose Sarah McLawler, who was a fantastic organist and pianist, and she blessed us many times. She would kick off her shoes and run her feet across the pedals there and make our organ sound like the Hammond B3 that she loved and took with her on tour and at other clubs. Also representing club owners, I had on the panel Lorraine from the Village Vanguard, Lorraine Gordon, Max Gordon's widow, who was running the as a club owner on the piano, and also Cobi Narita as a producer, there were, of course, Ingrid Jensen was an up-and-coming trumpet player, and Esmeralda Spalding, a great bass player, and there were about 40 women who were in the audience, it was their night, and it was a beautiful evening, they decided to meet again, that is where Cobi entered in, and she and really the result of that became the International Women in Jazz, and that was the beginning of it, and it's still going strong today, thanks to Cobi's really taking it over and being very instrumental in it. She and Paul Ash together were a great team. And Cobi were just fantastic together. So it was a beautiful time, and Cobi. So that is why we're here today, and it is amazing all the things that they had done together for jazz, and it's a beautiful time, and we thank them for it.
Beautiful day.
Thank you so much, Reverend Lynn. Cobi loved tap, believe it or not. She loved tap. We'd like to bring up our first tap performance of the evening. They are fabulous. Flew in from France to be here. Roxanne Butterfly and Zuli.
Two words. I am going to say just a few words because we took the long flight, and I'll be brief because I know a lot of people have so much to say. I come from a generation where European artists just didn't get green cards as tap dancers. And when women tap dancers got the gigs, but as a substitute or a fill-in in an all-male made production, and did not necessarily get fundings in the first round. And a time when tap dance itself within the jazz family was quite the poor parent. So within that landscape, in May of 1998, I came to Cobi. I already was a subscriber to her newsletter. And I was just back from a one-year contract in Las Vegas, where I had begun to learn conjugating the verb me too before it was even a word. And I went to her and I told her I think we need to have a whole women's collective. And she decided to help me put it together. Me, the paperless female merging tap dance artist. And so 26 years ago, on that board, quite a nice product, huh? It kept solid. Here, I got my first opportunity to showcase my work as a choreographer. Beauties and the Beat was born in this very place. Kim Clark actually was not on the first gig, but was a part of the experience. As a trade-off, because I wanted to send the ball back into her camp, I thought she needed to experience jazz from our side of living the culture. And I wanted to give her the opportunity to feel what it's like to be an artist, not only support the artist. So we secretly started seeing each other on Saturday in a dance studio called Fazio's in Hell's Kitchen. And I taught her the rudiments of tap dancing. She never wanted me to say it, because she supported so many tap jams that she was afraid people would ask her to tap. But now that she's swinging up in the heavens, I thought I could break the promise and tell the secret. So it was lovely to share those moments with her in that way. And if I have an image that resumes her spirit, it's Cobi, this quite old already for me, who was young, Japanese-American lady in her sweatpants, you know, white sweatpants, always very clean, with her ponytail bumping up and down, flapping around the studio, laughing at herself and enjoying sharing the process of making art, the best thing we can do on the planet. So 10 years later, she hears, my child is born. I live in Spain again. I'm an immigrant somewhere with less resource than if I had been in a country of my own. And she hears about the Down syndrome and my decision to stay on the other side of the water. Before I knew it, a check was in the bank to support my first year as a mom. So that's how Cobi was. She manifested support unsolicited, as the people who have known adversity know how to do. So this is for her. We're going to do a blues for Cobi. We didn't rehearse anything, but we know Kim Clark and she knows me, so we're just going to walk a blues. And as I have the mic, my daughter just lost her glasses, so if anybody finds glasses on the benches there, it's ours, and come and bring it to the stage. Thank you. And thank you to the family who brought us here, Suzanne. It's an honor.
Thank you so much. Wow. Okay, our next group consists of two separate performances. They're vocalists, and the first one, her name is Tina Fabrique, and with a name like that, you had better be good. And she is so good. Come on up, Tina, please.
I just want to say a couple of words. I know everyone has so much to say about this wonderful woman. And I think our history is about 40 years old. Yeah, I knew her about 40 years, introduced to her by Ralph Dorsey, the percussionist. I was part of that all-woman band that she put together. I performed at Bryant Park many times before it was Bryant Park. And she encouraged me, as she did everyone else, to do the very best you could with what you had and utilize what you had. Don't run away from it. Don't try to be different or don't try to be commercial. Just do what you got with what you got. And she encouraged me to be the jazz singer that I am today. She would come to every Broadway show. She would come anywhere that we were performing. And it has been a wonderful, wonderful relationship, Cobi. Thank you.
My funny Valentine, sweet Valentine's Day.
Thank you so much, Tina. Whew. Okay, it is time to move into the Asian American part of our program. So we have a speaker up first, who happens to be my sister, and she's of course right here. Yep, growing up, she was always that way. But she did have a few words to say. Boy, she's putting me in another predicament. We're gonna move on. And I'd like to introduce myself because she was supposed to introduce me. So now I'd like to bring up Kuni Mikami and the Asian American Jazz Band. It's just himself, actually. The thing about Asians is we're always working, were very industrious, and they couldn't make it. So it's Cooney, and he is amazing. If I could just say, we're gonna do an edited version of this song because the time is running long. And please, other performers, please be conscious of everyone that's gonna perform tonight. If you come up and start talking, their time gets shorter. So please make your comments very short and perform. That's what Cobi wants. She's telling me. Thank you. Short on dough, can't see a show, but you're in the know to go midtown to Cobi's place. You'll hunt along to music and song, you can't go wrong, so come along and go midtown at Cobi's place. Great time to see a movie and feel so groovy to sing whatever you like at open mic. Now that you know just where to go to see a show, won't spend all your dough. It's a happening at Cobi's place. Come join the folks, you'll have a great time and feel so sublime, 'cause maybe you can tap or maybe rap. Now that you know just where to go to see a show, won't spend all your dough. It's happening at Cobi's place, 158 West 48, between Sam Ash and Manny's. It's happening, it's happening, it's happening at Cobi's place. So, next up will be Michaela Marino Lerman, and they will be accompanied by a fabulous singer, Catherine Russell.
Hi, everybody. I just will keep it very, very brief. I have abundant, endless love and gratitude for Cobi Narita. She was an absolute blessing in my life, and I continue to receive blessings because of Cobi Narita. And her spirit of sharing is what I remember most and what I want to put in the world the most as I remember her. So all my love to Cobi Narita and family. Thank you.
All I can say about Cobi is Carlene Ray. That's all I can say. I'm representing.
Mm-hmm.
didn't know what time it was that I met you. Oh, what a lovely time it was, how sublime it was too. I didn't know what day it was, you took my hand, warm as the month of May it was, and I'd say it was grand, grand to be alive, to be young, to be mad, to be yours alone. Grand to see your face, feel your touch, hear your voice, say I'm all your own. I didn't know what time it was, life was no prize. I wanted love, and there it was, shining out of your eyes. I'm wise, and I know what time it is now.
Thank you so much. Whew. Is this a great show? Man, I'm glad I didn't have to pay for it.
We did pay for it.
Oh, that's right, we did pay for it. Thank you, Susan. Okay, so we're gonna move into, we have a speaker. We have a speaker. My mother worked with many, many groups, many organizations, but the Jazzmobile, right? So we have Jazzmobile's Robin Stevens Bell here to speak on behalf of Cobi.
Good evening, and as Cobi used to say, hello, friends. I have to say, it's being in this space, for many of us, I'm sure, is very meaningful. I'm sure, like many of you, you got to know Cobi through her passion and her love, and your passion and love for this great American classical music that we call jazz. And it was here that I actually first met Cobi. My late father played bass with a group called the Duke Ellington Orchestra. And thank you. And my dad brought me here for a concert that he was getting ready to do as a tribute to Duke. And I walked in, there was this little tiny person standing there, and all these folks were standing around her, and clearly everybody wanted her attention. So my dad and I, we waited. He went over and he introduced me to her. Her warm handshake, her kind smile, is something that I can think about and get that same warm feeling back as if it had just happened yesterday. And when I told her that I was just starting my career as a jazz presenter and wanted to one day be a jazz impresario like she was, she immediately said, get my number from your dad and call me anytime. I did, and she always took my call, or at least called me back the next day. She has been a phenomenal supporter of my own personal career, and as mentioned, she was a major supporter of Jazzmobile, never knowing when she was going to show up at one of our concerts, and always glad to see her. We make a fuss over her, and she say, no, I'm fine, I'll sit right over here. I said, not on my watch. So I escorted her to do the front, and everybody would always give her an applause when they saw that she was here. But one of the things that I remember too about Cobi, you often hear the saying, I may not remember what you said, but I will remember how you make me felt. With Cobi, it was both. She always had something important and meaningful and powerful and helpful to say just to you. And she always made you feel her kindness. So in closing, there is a poem that I came across. I'm not going to read the whole poem, needless to say, because I'm looking at Rob's eyes burning over my way. However, I do want to take a moment in closing. I want to leave you with the words, and I'm going to do some paraphrasing of the poet, and Ron, I apologize, and Susan, if I'm pronouncing her name correctly, but I'm going to give it my best shot, Ibaragi Noriko, and it's taken from her poem, When I Was At My Most Beautiful. When I was at my most beautiful, jazz poured from the radio. It was dizzy. And like smoking more, one more time after you stopped, I devoured his exotic, sweet music. So I decided, if possible, I'd live a long life. And what a long life she did live. Robin and Susan, thank you so much for sharing her with us for all these years. And Cobi, I do love you madly.
Oh my gosh. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Robin. Now, this past year has, 2023 and prior has been tough. We've lost so many of our compatriots, so many jazz and music legends have left us. And this next segment, I really want us to really appreciate those legends that are still here. And we're gonna honor them by putting them together. First up, we're gonna have Houston Pearson and Lafayette Harris. Thank you.
Thank you. Houston Person. Lafayette Harrison on piano. Wow. Beautiful. The way we were. Wow. We have a speaker who's going to come up. I believe he might have a performance in store for us as well. And we're talking the one and only Jimmy Owens.
Thank you very much. You know, being a jazz musician is very difficult. And those who have come before me saw how difficult it was, and they are the survivors of this music. And you know, we've never had many people to help us. Cobi Narita was someone who helped many, many jazz artists. And she saw the need to help many of the female jazz artists who were not getting any play whatsoever. Cobi was the executive director of the Collective Black Artists. She helped many, many jazz artists, both male and female, get grants, get concerts, get work. She helped build the Collective Black Artists. She wrote the first grants that gave us the money to not only pay her, but to pay the musicians that did numerous town hall concerts. This is my tribute to someone that I dearly loved for helping my friends, for helping so many people.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Jimmy. All right, up next, a very special man who's going to do a special tribute of his own for Cobi. After which we'll be followed by a George Coleman video. George couldn't be here, so he put together a video, and he will speak to us via video. So first up, Kenny Barron.
Thank you. Hello, my name is George Coleman, and we are here to celebrate a memorial for the great lady, Cobi Narita. She was such a beautiful lady, helped so many people musically and career-wise, got grants for, as a matter of fact, she got grants for me. And she was just wonderful. And God blessed her to be on the planet for a few years more than the regular people. Just like me, I'm 89, she was in her 90s, I think. But anyway, she was wonderful. She helped me in so many ways. Her institution was the Universal Coalition on Lafayette Street. And she had that place for many years, brought in a lot of bands, and really was just wonderful. A tribute to the profession and the music and everything positive. And we'll miss her. But in our hearts, she'll always be with us, just like all the great people in the world. And we need them because there's so much hostility, strife, and evil out here in this world. But her vibes will perpetrate and penetrate the world. And we're so happy to be memorializing her. And I'm happy to have been a part of some of the positive things she did for the music. She helped me so much. And Mr. Billy Harper's done quite well too to celebrate this memorial. So thanks to Billy too, great saxophonist. Anyway, that about does it for me. But that expresses my love. This video expresses my love for her, and she'll always be in my heart. Thank you so much.
Awesome. That's just wonderful. Okay, we're gonna keep moving. Up next, we have a special group that we put together of, when I first saw this in the program, it was OGs. Old gangsters? What? But legendary, legendary performers. And they're gonna do a couple of tunes for us, Soran Bushi and Croquet Ballet. And the group is Jimmy Owens, Billy Harper, Sharp Radway, Reggie Workman, and Aaron Scott. So we'll give them a minute, and they are going to tickle our fancies. To see Billy several times in concert. And I'll tell you, she would talk about him all the way home, all the way back to Oyster Bay. My mom wasn't necessarily the on and on kind of speaker, but when somebody impressed her, she would talk about it for a long time. And many of those people are sitting in here tonight. And one just stood up. But I'll tell you, she loved Billy's music. He's like, no, it's okay. He'd come over and hug Cobi. She said, you sounded so, no, it's nothing. All right. We're about ready. I should say,
they're about ready. Because I'm not singing. Unless they invite me. Okay.
See what we got in a minute. In a minute. I can't, I don't have to just put in a mouthpiece.
So this first song we're going to play is something called, I was in Japan and I heard this folk song called Soranbushi. And then it kind of stuck in my head, and I eventually did it.
I think you can hear me without this, right? Anyway, this folk song was called Soranbushi. And since it stuck in my head, I thought, well, it might be different to try to do a jazz version of this. And so I eventually got around to that, and this is called Soranbushi BH.
Thank you. Hey. You know, I thought you were hearing me when I was talking before without this. Really? Man, I talk so loud. I think. Oh, okay. Well, anyway, I mean, usually people are saying, hey, don't talk so loud. So, so I'm quieting it down a little bit. Oh, shoot. Anyway, that thing was called Sonobushi from that folk song, Japanese folk song. And it was jazzed up a little bit, you can tell, I guess. Yeah, I hope so. Okay, the next thing is something called croquet ballet. Croquet ballet. This came from, I was doing some music for a play, and in it they had the croquet game, you know, with the ball. Yeah. And so I decided, well, this is a good place to have a song. So I wrote this tune called it Croquet Ballet.
Thank you.
Thank you. Let's give a round of applause for our... And Mr. Workman on bass. Aaron Scott on drums. Thank you, thank you.
One more time, let's give him a... Woo! Oh, man. Thank you, baby. All right, so coming up. Okay, we've all heard of Piano and Bryant Park. And I'd like to bring up someone to speak about that. And right after that, we're gonna have some tap dance. The reason I'm putting them together is because Toz Tiranov was a big supporter of the Piano in Bryant Park. He got tap dancers to come out. So he's the one who really supported that and made that grow to what it is. So that's why I'm putting them together. I'd like to first bring up, though, Susan Siegel, who is the special project producer for the Bryant Park Corporation.
In the olden days, there was no such thing as a social media influencer. There were just influencers, movers and shakers who left their mark not by the number of followers they had, but by how many people they had touched. Their notoriety was earned not by posts generated, but because of the incredible work they'd done. Cobi was an influencer. The biggest. Especially when it came to the music biz. I first met Cobi through her husband and head cheerleader, Paul Ash. It was winter 2004. The Facebook, soon to be renamed Facebook, was just being launched. I was busy making code calls, trying to drum up sponsorship for a new program I was working on called Piano in Bryant Park. Sam Ash Music was at the top of my list. I picked up my desk phone, punch dialed the number, and lo and behold, Paul Ash, then president of Sam Ash Music, picked up the phone on the other end, like a real Don Corleone. Before I knew it, Paul had advised us on what equipment to order, paid for the entire construction of the piano, and arranged for a partner to offset performance fees. Oh, and did I mention, he also introduced us to his wife, Cobi Narita, only the most talented and renowned music promoter this side of the Atlantic. Now, if I could explain what a big deal Cobi was, it would take me all night. So let's just say she was like a secret weapon. Her Rolodex was filled with so many names and numbers that not even David Rockefeller could compete. Consequently, 4 months and 3 days later, on June 1st, 2004, there sat Frank Owens at the newly unveiled piano in Bryant Park. Terry Waldo followed the next day, and so it goes. The first couple of years, Cobi came to every performance. Only recently did I learn that for the first couple months, she personally escorted many of the players by driving them to and from the park each day, incurring parking costs along the way. And her advice, always straight and to the point, kept me going and still holds true. After reading a 17-paragraph email I wrote explaining piano logistics, Cobi wrote back, "Dear Susie, you sound tired. Love, Cobi." Her answer to the 35 questions I had about the new musicians added to the lineup, "Dear Susie, all fine performers. Love, Cobi." And her counsel when I wasn't getting along with one of the piano sponsors, "Dear Susie, grovel. Love, Cobi." Today, some 20 years later, Cobi's influence can still be felt, not only in the many original pianists who return summer after summer, but in the thousands of passerbyers who stop to enjoy a song or two and appreciate the sense of community that radiates from the dedicated group of listeners who come to Piano in Bryan Park every day. After all, there's always a party at the piano, and that's thanks to Cobi, our number one piano influencer and all that jazz.
Okay, we're gonna bring up Toes Tiranoff and Megan Hahn. So, hold on. Also on piano, Kuni Mikami. And the Asian American Jazz Band on bass.
This, Cobi was very welcoming to the tap community and really made it a part of the jazz community too. And we did many of her birthday parties right in the same place with amazing musicians, and it was all in alphabetical order. So I was by Clark Terry, and I forget who Megan was by, but it was pretty amazing, her birthday parties, and she was just an angel to us. And this dance is called the Bill Robinson. It's done to Doing the New Low Down. And it was choreographed by the Copacetics, who were a fraternity of master dancers, tap dancers, and musicians. And they did this dance as a homage to Bill Bojangles Robinson. And it became a ritual whenever a tap dancer or somebody really important passed away to do this dance for them. And we want to do it for Cobi Narita. Thank you.
Thank you, Toes and Megan. Okay. I have a very special singer coming up next, who will be followed by another very special singer. The first one is Andrea Wolper. And I will introduce the next one after that. He knows who he is.
Fine, thank you. Boy, that's a hard act to follow. Tap dancing, I love it. It's such an honor to be here, and I'm seeing so many people that I haven't seen in so many years. I think I might cry. I'm going to try not to. Because seeing all these familiar faces and old friends brings me back to the time that I met Cobi, Pastor Lind, hi. And that was really at a time when I was pretty fresh in the jazz world. And I know that finding that community was just so important for me. It meant so much to me. And Cobi was the hub of the wheel. Without question, yeah. And most importantly, I think that just by being herself, she really modeled a way to be in this world, to live a life in this crazy world. So I was thinking real hard about what to sing, and I thought something traditional, but what? And then I remembered this song that I'm sure many people know by Cannonball Adderley and John Hendricks. And I chose it because it's a great song and because a singer in California, Kathy Siegel Garcia, wrote some additional lyrics that I think about how to live, and I think Cobi just lived what these lyrics express. So. I want to tell all you people that the love that you feel for each other has a goal and a purpose and the power to heal the world. And if you go on ahead and you act on that power like Cobi did, feel the love for your brothers and your sisters, you're gonna feel the love around you, live in peace and happiness. This is the way that we can change the world for the better, just by living happy, making each action count for itself. Believe it or not, that's the way into holy. You're gonna feel all its power if you heed my humble ramblings to this sermonette. Thank you. that you won't soon forget. It talks about real true love. Some folks have lost sight of where their simple living. Scorn in the heaven above tells you to love one another. Please listen, sisters and brothers, do right, because you know you reap the things that you sow. And so to have no regrets and to find what you're missing, bow your head and listen to that sermon that about your head and listen to that sermon that.
Luciana Podmore, thank you.
Thank you so much. As a Broadway performer, this next gentleman shares that title with me. And he is one of the first people to join Cobi's open mic. And I am not sure how many years that was ago, maybe five or so. But he's gonna come up and he's going to do a special tribute to Cobi. Ira Collins, and on piano, Kuni Mikami.
Wondering what an 88-year-old white guy's doing here. It's a fluke. I can tell you it's a fluke. My friend, the late Joe Gimple, we both live in the Manhattan Plaza. Some years ago, he said to me, how would you like to be on an open mic on a Saturday afternoon? I said, sounds great, because these late ones, things at night are terrible. I said, sure, I'd love to. So the very first one, I went there. I was the only white person and the only non-jazz singer there. But for some reason, Cobi and Frank and Paul liked me, invited me back week after week, year after year. And I'm thrilled to be here tonight to celebrate her. Thank you. Baby, 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 love me, do, love me, true, the way that I love you, baby, 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 baby. I'm the kind of guy who would love to die if you should say we're through. You smile and I'm happy. You frown, then I'm blue. For me, there's no sunshine unless that sun shines for you. Baby, 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 take me, please. Set my heart at ease. Love me as I love you. You smile and I'm happy, I'm happy. you frown, then I'm blue. For me, there's no sunshine unless that sun shines for you. Oh, baby, 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 take me, please. Set my heart at ease. Love me as I love you. Baby, baby, baby.
Thank you, Ira. Thank you so much. Last performance, closing our show, is a gentleman who just came back from touring with the legendary Ron Carter. And he's a pianist. His latest album, As I Travel, killer, killer album. So he's going to close our show, and I'd like to introduce Donald Vega. Thank you. Oh my gosh, so many great performances tonight. I want to take this moment from the bottom of my heart to thank you all. Susan always also says thank you so much, everyone, for coming out and for participating in the honoring and celebrating of our mother Cobi's life. Thank you so much. I'd like to also introduce one final person, Cobi's younger sister, who's here from California, Therese Nakagawa. Thank you so much for coming out. Please, if you could start making your way into the reception, that would be great there. We have some great food, and everything is set up and to start going. So the musicians, if you can come forward, I'd love to take a picture with everyone, and I can send it out to all of you. But let's do that. Let's get a picture of all the musicians up here on stage. And we will have some entertainment coming also in the living room, in the reception. And Kuni Mikami will be playing piano, and we'll have Victor Lin playing violin, and we'll have singers and so many good things coming up. So for those of you who can, make your way to the reception area. Thank you.